We're coming up on approximately 5 years. So real close. I'm excited.
Let's go, boys!
It's very encouraging to know that what I love is reciprocated in terms of games.
We love video games. It's our escape. It's our home.
Hi, I'm Git Sasser. I'm the coordinator of esports at Catawba College. I also work with the digital signage and the Title IX investigation team. Been here for about 5 years now, so pretty excited to keep doing that. Esports actually goes all the way back to the 70s and the arcade boom and everything. So we're talking, you know, competition. You can look at that as being like, okay, hey, when Nintendo and Atari had their competition days with their arcades, you could call that like early esports. Now, the modern era, we're kind of in that 20-year window where you took the whole like Xbox, Microsoft, PC side of that, the internet boom, that kind of brought games to the global level. And once that started happening, you started to see the next stage of what is now esports. And then, you know, that naturally transitions into in-person major events, including like the one we had at Raleigh, like the LCS finals. So that's a really quick view, but you kind of follow the steps of arcade to internet to, you know, affordable home consoles, higher end TVs, and now everybody around the world has access to these video games and they can kind of compete with each other, and that pushes you to the next level. Like, okay, I don't want to just play with my friends. I want to take the skills I've developed and learned, the social aspect, and see what I can make out of it. And so now we have the college path, the professional path, franchise systems, entertainment, marketing, all that. So that is your super short, like, blurb on esports of history and how it grew into what it is. It's kind of like most programs where you have the idea of what you want to do, but until you get into it and really start seeing what's realistic, you never know what can pop up. So you know, for us, it was, hey, this is new. Esports in general is newer. So how do we approach it? What is the equipment that we need that will last? You know, so you're kind of guessing in the dark with PCs, chairs, tables, and then recruiting. You know, getting the message out saying, hey, we've got a new program. We can be competitive. It is, you know, in some people's minds, they think video games, well, what do you do? Like, hey, this is real. This is legit. Come get a scholarship. So a lot of getting it started was conversations to really help people understand, like, hey, this is a great opportunity, you know, commit to it. And for sometimes 5 years later, you know, you'll come out feeling like, hey, you had a great experience, both in esports and at Catawba College.
We established the program in 2019, so we're in year four now, led by Coach Git Sasser. We've continued to win with four conference championships thus far, and we want to continue to build on that tradition that he set. We also want to make sure that casual gaming is something that we offer out of our esports program, so I'd love to see us not only continue our varsity program, but also expand that for students interested in learning more about competitive esports, and also providing some opportunities for our students currently on campus, but also prospective students in high school about esports and video game playing at the collegiate level.
you know, we're not just showing up and sitting at a computer all day and looking at, you know, images on a screen, moving images, or playing games. We're actually building camaraderie. You know, there's that teamwork aspect, the skills that go into the corporate, non-corporate, private, et cetera, kind of environment. Like, how do we get you from here to graduation and into the post-college life, right? And so when you talk about that, like, the understanding of hardware, the understanding of social networks, the understanding of what it is like to be an active contributing member of society, that all plays a part in esports. It's just like athletics with baseball and football. They all started as just a game, right? And then people adopted that and saw, hey, there's more to this. There's more we can do than hit a ball with a stick. And so now we have, you know, the NFL, the MLB. It's the same with esports. We have franchise leagues all over the world. You know, this is a billion-dollar industry at this point.
This generation of college students grew up around video games. It's the only known lived experience that they have. And my experience with students is that they have involvement in video game playing in some form or fashion. They either are casually playing with apps on their phone, they're playing console gaming or PC gaming, or they know someone who is really involved and that's one of their main hobbies or interests as well. So I think there's always opportunities for us to further engage students. One of the reasons why I like video game playing is that not only can you play it, but you can also watch it. So you can be both a participant and an audience member and get that sense of community, just like sports here at the college.
We currently have 4 championships now in 4 years, so that's pretty exciting. That's across Valorant, League of Legends, so and Overwatch, and we're currently trying to go back-to-back for Overwatch, so we'll see how that goes. We go into semis next week, so top 4. I think as we're not a team anymore, if that makes sense. We're more like an entire athletic department. We're at the size of 54 scholarship students. So when, you know, we started the program, we were a team, right? You know, there was just League of Legends and there was Valorant and so on. And now we've grown into a department. So I think the teams as a whole are just going to continue to grow. We've been competitive from day one. So now it's more like, okay, how do we take that and continue to uphold that standard that we built on? And the struggle is that now we're up to like 7 to 10 teams a year under one department. So making sure we have the time and the capacity to keep everybody at that standard.
Hi, my name is Zachary Smith. I play Overwatch.
I heard it. Hi, my name is Joshua Worsler. I play Overwatch and Rainbow Six Siege. I've been playing on the esports team since last fall of 2022. I started halfway through the semester, and I've been playing through this whole spring 2023 semester.
Exactly the same. We joined at the exact same time. We've been playing the exact same length of time.
Hi, my name is Ryan Tyndall, and I am a Halo and Valorant player for Catawba Esports. I've been playing on the esports team for the past 3 years, going into my senior year now, and I still will be competing. The entire time I've been in school.
My name is Carter Mayhew. I play Rainbow Six Siege and Rocket League.
My name is Chris Basinger, and I play Rainbow Six and Rocket League as well.
I have been on the esports team for 4 years.
This is my second year on the esports team.
My name is Evan Tamburino, and I play Halo. This is my first year here. This is my second semester playing.
My name is Gabriel Vasquez, and I play League of Legends and used to play Smash Brothers.
How long have you been playing on the esports team?
Ever since I set foot on campus, 3 years. Yeah, as of now, 3 years.
My name is Chris, and I play League of Legends. I've been playing on the esports team for 4 years now.
My name is Carson Turlington, and I play and coach League of Legends, and I also help out with like the management stuff and running teams. I've been playing on the esports team for going on 4 years now.
My name is Hannah, and I play Valorant.
My name is Ivan, and I play Overwatch. For me, I think this is like my second semester, I believe. I wasn't really officially in last semester, so this is like my first one kind of being on an actual like team playing. So,
I've been in the program on scholarship since last spring.
My name's Clay Brown. I'm a sport management senior. Over my time here at Catawba, I've played Overwatch, Valorant, Halo. I played Apex a little while. So yeah, FPS gamer. I've been playing on the esports team for all 4 years.
What made me come to Catawba was one of my closest friends for the majority of my life. He was already going here, and I already had prior interest in esports. So, being from Chicago, I wanted to get out of state, and then I came on a visit here and absolutely loved it.
Mr. Sasser. He's basically the sole reason I ended up at Catawba. You know, a lot of things led me to stay at Catawba, of course. I've really enjoyed my time here. But at the end of the day, it was definitely good.
For me, definitely like the esports program. But originally, I was coming here for theater, but that kind of sidelined that a little bit. But I saw that we had a pretty cool like digital media lab and then the esports, so definitely those two things.
I love the esports program. It's fun. I mean, I get to play the games that I was playing anyway, but I get scholarship for it, and I get to get better at it with like help instead of just slumming it out on my own.
Being able to play the game without kind of consequences of I'm not getting productive out of this, even though it's something that I enjoy a lot as a hobby, is very important. The knowing that I'm playing something for a reason instead of just like, oh, I'm doing this for entertainment, I'm getting nothing done with my life. It feels like I'm really doing something and I'm getting better, a lot better.
I think for what it is, it's still kind of like a small-ish program. There's still a lot of us, but it's being conducted very well. We have one director kid, and I think he's been doing a really good job of organizing and like, you know, making us all feel welcome, and like we're like actually like a real sports program. So
I think the esports program is pretty good. I think it's very like equal, and everybody's treated how they should be treated. There's no like discrimination or anything towards like sex or
race.
Religion, race, yeah. Anything like that.
I think it's a pretty cool opportunity to like, you know, play video games competitively. I think that's like, especially if I go to like a really big school or something like that, I never would have gotten the chance. Most people kind of assume it's like out of their league, but then this program I think is a really good opportunity for that.
Fondest memory? Probably winning the league title freshman year.
Winning the Valorant title. Would be definitely my biggest memory, biggest moment as well. We all came together. It was a rough semester, I think, for all of us. But you know, once playoffs hit, we all got to the grindstone. You know, we made it work.
I think it was our third or fourth week game where there was a little mishap. We had to end up sitting there for maybe 30 minutes waiting for administrator, but in the end, we still won. And everyone was really hype after that game.
I liked the Catawba Clash. That was cool. The LAN that we did, that's what it was called, right?
Yeah, Catawba Clash.
Yeah, that was cool. We had all the different schools there.
Play because you love it. Play to improve and because you love it. And make friends using the thing that you love. At the end of the day, no matter if you want to go pro or not, just don't forget to have fun.
Do your homework and play your video game. That's kind of all you gotta do here.
Grind don't stop, work don't stop.
It's always possible to bring home a championship, so even when the odds are not stacked in your favor. So, I don't know. I think there's a lot you can take away from here, and yeah.